Well, praise the Lord again, and greetings in the most precious and wonderful name of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Again, I want to say to God be the glory for the great things He has done. I thank God for the phone calls and the support to this ministry. I trust God that today's program again would be a blessing to you. But just before we go any further, I would like to ask you if you would join in with me as we go before God in a time of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we come before you today in no other name but your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you, God, that from the rising of the sun, even to the going down of the same, your name is worthy to be praised. Lord, we lift our nation before you. We lift every listener before you. We ask that your Holy Spirit would guide and direct. We commit our lives into your hand. We thank you, God, for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, today, my friends, I would ask you to come with me right into the Word of God. And I'm going to the Old Testament, 2 Kings chapter 7, and I'm reading the 3rd and the 4th verse. It says, "And there were four leprous men at the entering in of the gate. And they said one to another, 'Why sit we here until we die? If we say, we will enter into the city, then the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. And if we sit still here, we die also. Now therefore come, and let us fall unto the host of the Syrians. If they save us alive, we shall live, and if they kill us, we shall but die.'" And I would like to speak to you for a while on choosing life by refusing to die. Choosing life by refusing to die. We live in a world today, ladies and gentlemen, where it seems as though everything now is very expensive. I remember there was a time when you would walk into the supermarket with a small purse full of money and walk out with a huge trolley full of groceries. But it seems as though today that is the other way around. You walk into the grocery with a trolley full of money and walk out with a purse full of groceries. That is because times are getting harder. And so, I want to encourage you today not to be discouraged, not to be despondent, but look up and live. There is a way out. There is a solution. There is someone who can help you. Times, my friends, are getting harder, but God is still on the throne. Today, ladies and gentlemen, it seems as though life is challenging men and women to the point where at times people feel it's better to be dead than alive. But I'm saying to you, that's a lie. Life is a wonderful thing. God created man to enjoy life. And so I want to encourage you, choose to live. My friend, there is nothing on this planet that is more precious to you than life. Why? Because where there is life, there is hope. As a matter of fact, in John 10:10, Jesus says, "The thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy." He says, "But I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly." So just imagine, my friend, Jesus journeyed all the way from heaven to earth just to bring you life. And not just any kind of life, but he says abundant life, meaning plentiful life. That's how important you are to God. My friend, that voice that is telling you right now to commit suicide, you'll be better off. That voice is none other than the voice of the devil himself. That spirit that keeps telling you to cut your wrist and to make a sacrifice with blood, that is not of God, that is of the devil. I plead with you today, please don't do it. There are many times I have been called to counsel young people who cut their wrists at times, all because a spirit of suicide plagued their life. I want you to know God loves you and He cares about you. You don't need to shed any blood anymore. Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, He has already shed His blood to take away your sins. Every 40 seconds, it is said that someone commits suicide. And I want to say to you today, don't be a victim of Satan's lie. He has been telling you, if you die, then all your problems would be over. I am telling you, my friends, if you die, your problems have only just begun. Now, this chapter here in 2 Kings chapter 7, we see that there was a famine in the land. In other words, there was a shortage. There was a scarcity. And because of that, people were dying because they had nothing to eat. It was really bad in Samaria. And maybe you are faced with a famine right now, hard times, like we would say, guava season in Trinidad. I want you to know that even in the guava season, God is still Jehovah Jireh. I want you to know that God can still make a way where there seems to be no way. There was a little woman in the Bible who her husband died and she was left in debt. The Bible says that the man of God spoke to her, and because she believed his word and acted on what he said, God made provision throughout the famine. I want you to know that God is still Jehovah Jireh. And so I want you to know you might be faced with your darkest hour, but the prophet of God, Elijah, he came on the scene just in time. And I feel as though I'm here just in time for somebody who prayed on last night, who got up this morning and asked God, where do I go from here? I want you to know I'm here to let you know God heard your prayer. The prophet said, hear the word of God. Thus saith the Lord, tomorrow about this time, you are going to have food. In other words, what he was saying is things are going to change. Listen to me, my friends. Things are going to change if you remain focused on God. And so today, I want to say to you who are feeling as though all is lost, listen to me. Listen to me carefully. Your present position is not your final destination. Every trial has an expiry date. You might be going through right now, but I'm here to tell you God is able to turn it around. Why not call upon Him? He said He's a present help in the time of your trouble. You see, the word of God came at the right time from the man of God. Maybe you accidentally turn to this channel. This is no accident, my friend. God heard you and He's making a way where there seems to be no way. He sent me to tell you that there is an assurance. He will make a way, but you must put your trust in Him. My friend, I believe that if you would only put your faith and your trust in Jesus, within the next 48 hours, God can turn that situation around. You don't have to die. You don't have to sit there and die. I am telling you, my friend, God can bring you out. God can do it for you. In the book of Luke chapter 18 and verse 27, Jesus says, "The things which are impossible with men, they are possible with God." But I want you to notice in verses 3 and 4, it says that there were four leprous men at the entering in of the gate. And they said one to another, "Why sit we here until we die?" I want you to notice these four men, they were sick, they were diseased, and they were outcasts, but they wanted to live. In other words, they refused to die. I want to say to somebody today listening to me, no matter what your situation might be, choose life. You may think that it's over, but it's not. Choose life. Suicide is a cop out. Don't quit. Don't back down when you know that God is backing you up. I don't care if it is even a life-threatening situation. In Deuteronomy chapter 30 and verse 19, God says, "I call to heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursing. Therefore, choose life, that both you and your children may live." So the choice you make today, it would not only affect your life, but it would affect your children also. Listen to me, lady. That decision that you're making to do wrong, it would not only affect you, but it would affect your children. It would affect that daughter. What about you with that young child that is now growing up? They are depending on you. The day would come when they would sit for the graduation ceremony, and it would be a blessing to have you sitting in the audience and cheering them on. Don't give up. Don't give up. I don't know who it is I'm talking to, but there is somebody who feel like giving up. Don't give up. God will see you out. God will bring you through. It might be tough. Tough time never lasts, but tough people always last. Listen to me. These four men decided, we are going to make it. And I'm saying to somebody listening to me, you are going to make it. I heard what the lawyer said. I heard what the doctor said. I heard what people are saying. But have you heard what God is saying to you right now? He is saying to you, choose life. Live. Don't give up. Why should you give up when God is on your side? I want to remind you that you cannot go under for trying to go over. The battle is not yours. The battle belongs to God. And so today, I want to pray for you. I want to trust God with you. I want to believe God with you. Would you bow your heads with me right now? Heavenly Father, I bring that man, that woman, that boy, girl that is listening to this broadcast right now. And I pray in the name of Jesus that through your Holy Spirit, the anointing will destroy the yoke and set them free in Jesus' name. Amen. Hear me very quickly. There's a number on the screen. I want you to call that number. Someone would be waiting to pray for you. God bless you. Until next time again, I love you. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up.